Maypole Dream. Once upon a time, Old King Winter had finally left the land, and at last the spring breezes were ringing the little snowbell flowers. These merry tinklings brought the fairies tiptoeing out from their winter houses, hoping to see some bright spring colors. But what a sad surprise they had when all they found was muddy browns and grays and greens as far as they could see. Where could all the bright spring colors be? The fairies cried together. The children will be sad. We have to help them. They ran here and there and looked for the colors under toadstools, behind the trees, and under stones. Alas, no bright spring colors could they see, only all the dull colors from the end of winter. Soon their spring joy turned to sorrow, and they sat sadly together. Little fairy called out in a tiny little voice, "Let's ask Mother Earth. Surely she will help us." The fairies all leaned in to listen to the tiny little one, and then they all agreed. So deep and deeper into the forest they ran. They heard the old one singing. "Spring is coming, spring is coming, birdies build your nest. Weave together straw and feather, each doing its best. Spring is coming, spring is coming, all around is fair. Shiver, quiver, joy is everywhere." There sat the good Mother Earth, wrapped in her shawl, with all the spring flowers waiting. They were getting ready to bloom and bring bright colors to Mother Earth's spring dress. But they were sad too, so very sad, for there were no spring colors to be had. The fairies hung their heads. "Mother Earth, what shall we do? Where shall we find the colors good and true?" Mother Earth just simply smiled and said, look up in the sky above, and there you will find them, full of love." So up they danced to the tallest hill. They raised their heads and looked up high. A rainbow bridge in the sky above, with all of the colors, was shining with love. With a gleeful squeal, they turned round and round and raised their arms without a sound. "Thank you," they sang to the rainbow above. Thank you for the colors of love." The fairies of the dark earth looked up to the light and found a rainbow in the middle, a wondrous sight. Then their voices rang out like little bells. "Oh, help us, rainbow fairies, if you care, and send us your colors through the air." Then all of a sudden, in a flash and a dash, the rainbow sent its fairies with streams of colors to the earth. They slid down the rainbow and danced on the ground, twirling their streamers around and around. danced up to a tree. They gave her their streamers, and she then set them free. Now, Earth Fairies, come. Come and dance with me. The Earth Fairies ran, and they sprang. They danced, and they sang. And the ribbons spread their colors all through the air. The trees began to glimmer. The sky began to shimmer. The grass began to glow. And each flower raised its head with a bright new hat of color. As the children left their houses, they found surprises in the gardens. In the bright green leaves, there were flowers orange and yellow, purple and blue, and buds of red were peeking through. The children all were smiling, and their eyes began to shine. Children, come, called the fairies. Come and dance on the green, and say thank you to the colors that we have long not seen. The children started singing, weaving flowers on the way into crowns for their heads. Then with rainbow ribbons in their hands, they danced a spiral in and out around the lovely maypole tree. And every spring since then, when you hear the fairies calling, children dance around the maypole, weaving ribbons from above. They're saying thank you to the colors they all love. Come and dance with me, come and dance with me all around the maypole tree. Come and dance with me.